A very good afternoon, students. Today I'm going to explain the theory of corrosion or mechanism of corrosion. But before going to see the corrosion, that is theory of corrosion, just let us recall what is mean by the corrosion. Corrosion is nothing but destruction of metal with unwanted impurities or with electrolyte in the environment. Destruction of metal with unwanted impurities or electrolyte in the environment is called the corrosion. Yes. So we know where the corrosion takes place. Corrosion generally takes place at anode. So we know what reaction takes place at anode. Generally at anode oxidation reaction takes place, at cathode reduction reaction takes place. So here simply corrosion is nothing but the oxidation. And especially the corrosion takes place at anode and also takes place at the less exposed part or less concentrated part. So wherever the oxygen concentration is less, wherever the exposed part is less, less exposed part is acting as an anode and there corrosion takes place. Yes. So that was the previous class. So today let us see what is the theory of corrosion or mechanism of corrosion. But before that, you know what is mean by the mechanism? Mechanism is nothing but the process of reaction. The process of reaction is called the mechanism of corrosion. But we know that metal is undergo corrosion either in the dry condition or in the wet condition. That means either the metal is undergo corrosion in the absence of moisture or in the presence of moisture. So based on that, we are having two types of mechanism. When the metal is reacting, so let us assume this is a metal. So when the metal is reacting in the presence of moisture, the process of reaction is different, the process of corrosion is different. But when the metal is reacting or when the metal is exposed in the absence of moisture, the process of the corrosion is different. So based on the medium, based on the electrolyte or based on the medium, we are having the two types of mechanisms. So one is called the dry theory of corrosion and second one is the wet theory of corrosion. So one is dry theory of corrosion. Dry theory is also called as chemical corrosion. And the second type of corrosion is the wet corrosion. Wet corrosion is also called as the electrochemical corrosion. But we know what is the other name of electrochemical. Electrochemical is also called as galvanic. So electrochemical corrosion and it is also called as the galvanic corrosion. So on which basis we are having two types of theories? Based on the medium in the environment, either in the presence of moisture or in the absence of moisture. So based on that medium, we are having two types of theories. One is dry theory of corrosion and the wet theory of corrosion. Dry theory of corrosion is also called as the chemical corrosion and the wet theory of corrosion is also called as the electrochemical theory of corrosion, or it is also called as the galvanic corrosion. So today I am going to explain the dry theory of corrosion. It is very, very important to you. These two are very, very important for the long questions. So today I am going to explain the dry theory of corrosion. So dry theory of corrosion. Dry theory of corrosion. So what is mean by the dry theory of corrosion? Dry theory of corrosion is nothing but the corrosion of the metal in the absence of moisture. That means metal is undergo destruction only by reacting with the dust particles in the environment and it is not reacting with the moisture in the environment. That is the dry theory of corrosion. But what is there in the environment? Here, is there only moisture in the environment? No, along with the moisture, various chemicals are present in the environment. So what are the chemicals present in the environment? In the environment, oxygen, chlorine and also nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus, yes, And these chemicals are present in the environment. Along with it, oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen, oxides of phosphorus, yeah, these are present in the environment. So when the metal is reacting with these chemicals in the environment, corrosion takes place. That corrosion is called dry theory of corrosion. Yes. So when the metal is undergo corrosion due to reacting with oxygen, chlorine, sulfur, nitrogen, phosphorus, and oxides of sulfur, nitrogen, and phosphorus is called dry theory of corrosion. But here, metal, when it is reacting with the oxygen, a layer is forming on the surface of the metal. So based on that, the dry theory of corrosion is classifying into three types. One is oxidation corrosion. One is called oxidation corrosion. And second one, corrosion of the metal with another gases, corrosion by other gases. And other type of corrosion is liquid metallic corrosion. So these are the three types of corrosion in dry theory of corrosion based on the reactivity of metal with the chemicals in the environment. So that's the reason dry theory of corrosion is also called as a chemical corrosion, because instead of reacting with the moisture, metal is reacting with the chemicals. So this is also called as a chemical corrosion. But based on the reactivity of metal with these chemicals, the dry theory of corrosion is further classifying into three types. One is oxidation corrosion, corrosion by other gases, and the liquid metallic corrosion. So let us see one by one. The first one is oxidation corrosion. So what is oxidation corrosion? When the corrosion takes place in the presence of oxygen. So when the metal is undergo corrosion in the presence of oxygen, that is called the oxidation corrosion. What is corrosion by other gases? When the metal is reacting with remaining gases except oxygen, that is called corrosion by other gases or corrosion by other chemicals. And the last one is the liquid metallic corrosion. I will explain you later. So let us see one by one. The first one is oxidation corrosion. So what is oxidation corrosion? Corrosion of the metal in the presence of oxygen is called the oxidation corrosion. But we know in periodic table, we are having two types of metals. One is alkali metals and the alkaline earth metals. Yes, along with that, we are having some more metals. That is silver, aurum, platinum. Yes, we are having the first group elements, second group elements, and also silver, aurum, and the platinum. Yes, but here the reactivity of these metals are depending on the oxygen. Here the reactivity of metal with oxygen is depending on the temperature. Yes, it is especially depending on the temperature. Here first group elements, these are reacting with oxygen only at low temperature. These are reacting with oxygen only at low temperature. That means when the temperature is less, then only the first group elements are undergo oxidation corrosion. But whereas alkaline earth metals, that means the second group metals, these are also reacting with the oxygen, but only at the high temperature. That means when the temperature is more, then only the second group elements are undergo oxidation corrosion. There are some more metals, these are not reacting with the oxygen at any temperature. Those are called noble metals, not noble gases, noble metals. Those noble metals are silver, aurum, and platinum. Here silver, aurum, and platinum, these are not reacting with oxygen at any temperature. So these are called noble metals. Yes. So that is oxidation corrosion. Yes. But I said you now, when the metal is exposing to oxygen for a long time, a layer is forming on the surface of the base metal. This is the layer. A coating or layer is forming on the surface of the metal. This layer is called oxide layer. This is called the oxide layer. But here, all oxide layers are not similar. Some of the oxide layers are diffusing inside the metal. Some of the oxide layers are evaporating continuously and removing continuously. And some of the oxide layers are having the holes. Here, all types of oxide layers are not similar. Yes, some are going inside, are penetrating inside, and some of the oxide layers are evaporating, and some of the oxide layers are disappearing, and some of the oxide layers are having some holes. Yes, so based on the nature of oxide layer, we are having four types of oxide layers. There are four types of oxide layers based on the nature. So those are stable oxide layer, second one, unstable oxide layer, and the third one, porous oxide layer, and the last one, volatile oxide layer. So these are the four types of oxide layers. Let us see one by one. Stable oxide layer. So maybe you can observe on the copper metal, but whatever the copper materials we are using at home, that is not pure copper, that is the alloy, because copper is not stable. Copper is forming the oxide layer which is stable. Yes, here stable oxide layer is nothing but the oxide layer which is strongly sticking to the surface of the metal. Here this is the metal and this is the oxide layer. This oxide layer is strongly sticking to the surface of the base metal, and the entire metal efficiency is reducing due to forming the stable oxide layer. In stable oxide layer, the oxide layer is strongly sticking and firmly sticking to the surface of the base metal. That is called the stable oxide layer. And in stable oxide layer, after some time, the entire metal is forming an oxide layer, that is a stable oxide layer, and there is no further corrosion of inside of the metal because this oxide layer is not diffusing inside. It is not going inside. So only the external layer is undergo corrosion in the stable oxide layer. Example, copper, tin and lead. These three metals are forming the stable oxide layer. And the second one, unstable oxide layer. Already I explained you in oxidation corrosion. There are some metals which are not reacting with oxygen at any temperature. Those metals are called the noble metals. So these noble metals are not reacting with oxygen at any temperature, but these are forming an oxide layer which is not stable. Like previous, in stable oxide layer, the layer is strongly sticking to the base metal, that means the surface of the metal. But whereas in this, in the noble metal, initially forming a layer which is not stable, that means a layer is forming on the surface of the metal, a layer is forming, but after washing, after washing with the chemicals, or after that, after some time, this layer is disappearing because this is not stable oxide layer and this is not strongly sticking to the surface of the metal. That is pure silver, pure aurum and pure platinum. These are not forming any oxide layer, that is unstable oxide layer. Yes, so unstable oxide layer means the layer which is not stable and which is not strongly sticking to the surface of the metal. That is unstable oxide layer. Example is the noble metal. Those are silver, aurum and platinum. And the next one, porous oxide layer. In the name only we have porous oxide layer is nothing but the oxide layer is having the pores. So the best example of porous oxide layer is iron. So here iron is undergo corrosion in the presence of moisture and also in the absence of moisture. But in the presence of moisture, it will take only 2 to 3 years to undergo corrosion, to undergo the entire metal undergo corrosion. But whereas in the absence of moisture, it is a slow process. It will take around hundreds of years to undergo corrosion. But in the porous oxide layer, assume this is the iron. When the iron is exposing to the oxygen continuously to the environment, a layer is forming on the surface of the metal, but which is porous. That means which are having the small pores, small holes. Through these holes, again the dust particles or the again oxygen is reacting with the surface of the metal, because it is having the holes. Again a layer is forming which is having holes, which is having the pores. Again the dust particles are reacting with the surface of the metal. So it is the continuous process. This process is continuous till the whole metal undergo corrosion. Here the entire metal is undergo corrosion, but it will take a long time to undergo corrosion. Yes, so only the best example of porous oxide layer is iron. And the last one, volatile oxide layer. Example is molybdenum. So now I will explain what is mean by the volatile oxide layer. Volatility is nothing but which can be evaporating easily. That is volatility, which can be evaporating easily. That is volatile nature. So here, when the molybdenum metal, this is molybdenum metal, when the molybdenum metal is exposing to the oxygen or reacting with the oxygen, a layer is forming on the surface of the metal. That is a volatile oxide layer. This volatile oxide layer is evaporating. So you know what is evaporation? It is undergo evaporation. But some of the oxide is, some of the layer is diffusing inside of the metal, and some of the oxide layer is evaporating to the environment. So again the surface is exposing to the environment. Some of the layer is going inside, and again the surface is exposing to the environment. That means again it is reacting with the oxygen and again forming a volatile oxide layer. Again this volatile oxide layer evaporating and also diffusing to the environment, sorry, metal. Some of the oxide layer is diffusing inside of the metal, and some of the oxide layer is evaporating, and again the surface is exposing to the oxygen. So it is the continuous process till the whole metal is undergo corrosion. Yes, so in the porous oxide layer, due to having the pores, the entire metal is undergo corrosion. But in volatile oxide layer, due to diffusion or due to penetrating, the entire metal is undergo corrosion. Yes, so those are oxide layers: stable, unstable, volatile and the porous. In stable oxide layer, only the surface of the metal is forming the oxide layer, and which is very strong. But whereas in unstable oxide layer, the metal never undergoes corrosion due to forming unstable layer. In volatile oxide layer, due to evaporation and the diffusion, the entire metal is undergo corrosion. And in porous oxide layer, due to forming a porous oxide layer, the entire metal is undergo corrosion due to reacting the dust particles through the holes. Yes, so that is oxidation corrosion. And the next one, corrosion by other gases. That is very simple. Corrosion by other gases is nothing but the metal is reacting with the remaining gases in the environment. Same like the oxidation corrosion, when the metal is reacting with the remaining gases in the environment, either it is forming the protective layer or the non-protective layer. That depends on the nature of the metal. Yes, that is depends on the nature of the metal. Either it is forming the protective layer or the non-protective layer. You know what is protective? The stable layer. Stable layer is the protective layer because there is no further corrosion. But unprotective is nothing but the volatile oxide layer. This is a non-protective layer because this layer is not protecting the base metal. Because of that, the entire metal is undergo corrosion in porous oxide layer and the volatile oxide layer. So that is corrosion by other gases. And the last one, liquid metallic corrosion. Yes, so we should not hear the word liquid in the dry theory of corrosion, but still we are listening that word liquid, because initially it is not in the liquid medium, it is in the form of semi-solid, that is in the molten state. So especially in some industries, they are sending the mercury inside the pipes, inside the metallic pipes. So assume this is a metallic pipe. When they are sending the molten mercury inside, you know what is mean by molten? Molten is nothing but the semi-solid. So when they are sending the molten mercury inside of the metal, so when this type of metallic pipes are exposing to the environment, at one of the stage, due to the external temperature, due to the temperature, when the temperature is very high, this molten metal is converts to the liquid state. Yes, so at one of the stage, the molten mercury is converts to the liquid state. So when it is converts to the liquid state, this mercury is penetrating inside of the metal. So when it is penetrating inside of the metal, the entire metal is undergo corrosion due to converts to the liquid state. That is liquid metallic corrosion. Yes. So especially we can observe the liquid metallic corrosion in the small scale industry due to sending the molten mercury to the metallic pipes. Because this molten mercury is converts to the liquid mercury. This liquid mercury is penetrating inside of the metal and undergo corrosion. So that is dry theory of corrosion. So along with that, we are having one of the theory, that is one of the rule. So I will explain that rule based on the oxidation corrosion or the based on the oxide layer. We are having one rule, that is Pilling Bedwards rule. It is very, very important for short questions, Pilling Bedwards rule. But before going to see the Pilling Bedwards rule, I will define you what is specific ratio. This specific ratio is useful in the Pilling Bedwards rule. Specific ratio is nothing but it is the ratio of metal oxide volume and the metal volume. Again, I am repeating. Specific ratio is nothing but it is the ratio of metal oxide volume and the metal volume. So we can write the formula of specific ratio as specific ratio is equals to metal oxide volume divided by metal volume. Metal oxide volume divided by metal volume. Yes. So that is specific ratio. So what is metal volume? What is metal oxide volume? So assume this is metal and this is metal oxide. That what oxide layer? Oxide layer is nothing but metal oxide here. This is metal and this is metal oxide. See, in this example, the metal volume is less. The volume of the metal is less, but whereas the metal oxide volume is more. So I will take another example. This is metal and this is layer. This is the metal oxide layer. In this example, the metal volume is more and metal oxide layer volume is less. Yes. So here metal oxide is nothing but this, that is the volume of metal oxide, and this is metal volume. Yes. So what is specific ratio? Specific ratio is nothing but it is the ratio of metal oxide volume and the metal volume. So Pilling Bedwards rule is nothing but if specific ratio is more, metal is protective. If specific ratio is less, metal is non-protective. If specific ratio is more, metal is protective. If specific ratio is less, metal is non-protective. So when the specific ratio is more, when metal oxide is more compared to metal volume. So when the numerator is more compared to the denominator, then only specific ratio will be more. Yes. So what is numerator? Metal oxide layer. So we know here metal oxide layer volume is more compared to metal volume. That means this metal is covered by the layer. When the metal is covered by the layer, is there any further corrosion? There is no further corrosion. That means metal is protective. That's what, when the specific ratio is more, metal is protective. But when the specific ratio will be less, when the numerator is lesser. What is numerator? Metal oxide layer is less compared to metal volume. Seeing this, metal oxide layer volume is less compared to the metal volume. So when the oxide layer volume is less, see, this part is exposing to the environment, this part also exposing to the environment. So there is further corrosion because this layer is not protecting the environment. Yes, so entire metal is not protected by this layer. So metal is not protective when this layer volume is less. Layer volume less means specific ratio is less. Yes, so what is Pilling-Bedwell's rule? When the specific ratio is more, metal is protective. When specific ratio is less, metal is non-protective. So this is dry theory of corrosion. In the next class, let us see what is wet theory of corrosion. Thank you so much.